For those of you who might not know, AWS and SAP, we are great partners since over 16 years. But we are also very proud that Amazon runs on SAP and that more and more organizations within Amazon use RISE for their own transformation. Tell us a bit more, Matt, about why does Amazon run on SAP and what is the experience with our platform?
Yeah, and thank you. And it has been a fantastic partnership over the years and continues to get bigger and bigger over time, so thank you. And that includes using SAP inside of Amazon, as you mentioned. And inside of Amazon, there are several organizations that use SAP. Teams like Twitch and Zappos use it for mission-critical workloads. Just last week, we actually announced that Kuiper, which is our ambitious program to deliver broadband access to many underserved communities all around the world via a satellite network, chose RISE on SAP. Now, Kuiper is this broadband internet access that's going to need 3,000 satellites all around the world in order to provide this service. And if you think about needing to launch and manufacture 3,000 satellites over the next couple of years, that means we have to manufacture and deliver a couple of satellites every single day. That is an incredibly complex task. That requires a global supply chain, it requires manufacturing and high-tech parts from all over the world, and SAP RISE is what helps us manage that and keep track of all of those pieces. Super important for us, and it allows the Kuiper team to take advantage of SAP's business AI capabilities as well.
Yeah.
All, of course, powered on AWS and our global secure infrastructure, of course.
Important. And look, I mean, just to build on that, and Kuiper reached out, they needed a software, a system, a platform to scale their business, especially in the manufacturing and supply chain area. The business, IT, the partner, and our architects were sitting together to combine the needs of the business reflected in our software, run on AWS. Our RISE offering also includes the best of the best technology across the stack. Now, thousands of customers have selected AWS and SAP to run their mission critical workloads. What are the main reasons for our joint customers to do that?
Yeah, thanks. And thank you to many of you who are AWS and SAP customers out there. And you're right, the momentum is actually incredible between the two companies. We have customers like Aflac and Hyundai and Kia, HP Inc., Zurich Insurance, many customers and thousands more running RISE on AWS today. And there's a couple reasons for that. Let's take an example of somebody like Moderna. Now, many of us are familiar with Moderna, who fortunately for all of us, was one of the first to come out with a COVID-19 vaccine, which is awesome. And if you think about Moderna, they started on AWS from the very first time. And one of the things they look for in their cloud infrastructure is how do they develop life-saving vaccines, but how do they do it quickly? Now, they've entrusted AWS since the very first time that they started the company, but now they're also using RISE on AWS to support their continued growth and innovation. And it's customers like this, if you think about what they need, they need, number one, security. They need absolute reliability of that infrastructure. And they need great performance and scale in order to deliver what they need. And that scale is a super important one. Actually, just last week, we announced the GA of our latest high-memory EC2 instance. It's the first virtualized cloud instance to support 32 terabytes of memory. So the ability to support the very largest SAP workloads out there, and that's generally available today for all of our RISE customers. So, as you can tell, we have a long history of innovating together. AWS was the very first place that SAP ran in a cloud environment, and we'll continue to innovate together as part of this great partnership.
Matt, you wouldn't imagine how many customers waited for this 32 terabyte machine. But anyway, look, Moderna, by the way, I mean, what a success story. During COVID, the business obviously needed to ramp up. AWS, SAP on their side, not only to scale up their compute, but also helping them to keep the supply chains resilient. And now they are on an ongoing journey to a modification-free cloud ERP. Now, AWS is not only powering RISE, our platform, but it's also powering SAP Business AI across the stack. I talked about Joule. I talked about our Gen AI Hub. Yep. How are the AWS capabilities in detail contribute to the success of our business AI?
Yeah, well, first, we're proud to power Joule and your generative AI hub, so we're excited about that. And you're right, the customer opportunity out there in AI is massive. It wouldn't be a tech conference if we didn't talk about AI, so I'm glad you brought it up, thank you. But if we think about that, look, I've talked to a lot of customers out there who are thinking about how do I go build AI applications. And when I think about it, there's a couple things I think about. First, I need model choice. Two, I need cost controls. These things can get really expensive. And three, I need security. And so if you think about what AWS delivers, we deliver this across, we call kind of three layers of the stack when you think about AI. The first is you need a very high performance infrastructure at the base layer of that stack to really support all of your training and inference workloads. Second, you need an awesome set of tools in order to go build AI applications. If you're out there building an application, you need to have tools that can allow you to have security and compliance guardrails and capabilities and build agents and use multiple models together. And the third layer of the stack, you're going to need generative AI applications that come from both AWS as well as many of our partners like SAP. And so we're proud to partner with you on all three layers of this stack. Now, if you think about that base layer of the stack, that's the high-performing infrastructure stack. AWS has by far the best-performing, most secure infrastructure for running AI workloads. We're the best place to run GPU and NVIDIA-based workloads by far. And I'm proud to announce that SAP is a partner using our custom developed Trainium and Inferentia instances, which use Amazon's own processors that for certain workloads can save you up to 50% of your costs over other EC2 instances. Now, at that next layer up the stack, you think about, you have a really high performing infrastructure. What is that application layer that helps you go build applications? And this is where a lot of our partnership and integration is happening. We have a service called Amazon Bedrock. It's a fully managed service that makes it super easy for you to go build generative AI applications. We give you a choice of high-performing foundational models, so you can pick the very best model or combine different models to build the application you're looking for. And we give you the ability to do things like guardrails so that you can have responsible AI, so you can have privacy and security, you can have compliance, you can do all of those things, you can test the best models. Now, we're super excited today to announce that Bedrock is being integrated in with SAP's Generative AI Hub. So now, SAP customers can take the best of Bedrock, all of those capabilities to go build a generative AI application that includes access to the very best models, including Anthropic's Claude 3 models and Amazon's own Titan foundational models. And you can take those models and then combine them with the data that you have inside of your SAP systems to build fantastic new applications yourself, all customized with the Bedrock toolset.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Matt. And indeed, yeah, we are putting our engineering teams really closely together to really, you know, give the best business AI across the stack. Now, talking about BTP and HANA Cloud, and I can remember we talked 2 years ago about what can we do for the scalability, the performance, and the sustainability of our cloud environment. So we decided, and now today we are going to announce it, that BTP, HANA Cloud, including DataSphere, will run in the future on ARM-based processors, AWS Graviton.
Yeah.
What can our customers expect from a performance and sustainability perspective?
Well, it's awesome, and thank you very much for leaning into Graviton. It's super exciting. I remember when we first started talking about that many years ago.
Yes.
And so for those of you who don't know, Graviton is the AWS custom-produced line of processors that are based on ARM, and they deliver meaningfully better price performance than comparable opportunities. You mentioned sustainability, super important to everybody out here, and Graviton actually uses 60% less energy compared to an x86 comparable processor. Awesome for all of you that are focused on your carbon footprints out there. And you all were very early adopters of Graviton, and you saw those performance gains. You actually get markedly better performance, just straight up performance at a lower cost. It's an awesome platform, and super excited to see the new applications coming to Graviton, and in particular, BTP. And speaking of BTP, I also want to mention that really excited that I think just yesterday, we launched a BTP edition of our AWS SAP SDK that allows all of you developers out there to much more easily build and combine BTP capabilities with all your various other AWS services and AWS environments that you're building on. I'm super excited about this. I think it really shows that tight integration and the engineering partnership that we have together. And frankly, I'm thrilled about the future of our partnership together and how all of you can take advantage of that.
Matt, I want to thank you for your personal commitment to our partnership. We talked about it, we delivered. That's super important. And also, I want to thank the entire Amazon team for this great partnership we are having since so many years. Thanks a lot, Matt.
Awesome. Thank you. Thanks, everyone.